na rä u kå ngä kå nä harä må ndå ona å mwe wanyu å ä å ndå
kana kä gä
gia andå aya
or something that is not allow this
people
be married as man and wife. That person must say it now. And if he does not do so, or she does not do so, never ever say it anywhere else.
Kana gukorwo gutirĩ ona ũmwe mũndũ ũcio agĩkire na ndakanae ũkoiga ona rĩ kana rĩ
This is time now to check whether the person presented by the parents is the one the bridegroom knows and want to marry, or a substitute who could be a sister, a cousin, or any other person. So it's time now to open, to unfail the nets and check whether this is the person he really want to marry, his sweetheart, whether she's the one or not. She is the one, and he is happy now. So the ceremony will go on to make sure they are joined together in holy matrimony, and it's a joyful occasion because people have related inside there. There was a relation and celebration, and it is continuing now to go to the vows, as it is tradition in this particular
case. We look forward on this congregation to declare that Beatrice is your wife, and that it is your desire to live together with her in the biblical covenant of marriage.
Yes, I mean.
We also declare that you will at all times love her, cherish her, honor her, comfort and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live.
Yes, I mean.
To give you a coffee. Will you before God and this congregation declare that Charles is your husband and that is your desire to live with him in the biblical covenant of marriage? Wangufu, wangufu.
Yes, I
will. To be a magofi. And will you declare that you at all times love him, cherish him, honor him, comfort and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Atubikie makofi tushangilie wote tafadhali. Asante, asante, asante. It is time of making vows.
I, Charles, declare before God and this congregation assembled here, that you, Beatrice, you are my beloved wife, to have and fruit, for better for us, for richer for glory, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, to honor in the Lord, till we are separated by death, according to God's holy law. And this is my solemn vow, Beatrice, in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I, Beatrice, declare before God and this congregation assembled here that you, Charles, you are my beloved husband, to love and to hold, for better for us, for richer for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, and to honor in the Lord, till we are separated by death, according to God's will. And this is my solemn vow, Charles, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
That you are my beloved wife, with all that I have and all that you have, I honor you. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you. She shall be called woman, for she was taken
out of the man. That is why a man leaves his father and mother and is united to his wife, and they become one flesh. Adam and his wife were both naked, and they felt no shame. This is the word of God.
It comes from the book of Ephesians chapter 5, from verse 21 to 29. Where Efeso tano, kuanzia 21 hadi 29, and I will read. Submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives, submit yourselves to your own husbands as you do to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of his church, of which he is the Savior. As the church submits to Christ, so as also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word. 27. And to present her to himself as a radiant church, without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. In this same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own body, as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. The last verse, after all, no one ever hated their own body, but they faith and care for their body, just as Christ does the church. And that is the word of the Lord.
Yeah.
Thank you, my viewers, for following me. Thank you for following this wonderful wedding ceremony. Thank you so much. I love you wherever you are. Remember, this continues. And like and subscribe. Bye.